Yeah, just starting the show, Red.
Sorry, I'll wait for your intro.
Okay, thanks, Red. Cueing the network logo. Secrets, if you really look at yourself, you would be speechless. What happened to being doctors and teachers? What happened to being your brother's keeper? Nowadays, kids more worried. Hey folks, 13 here, and we're about to play Beasts of Prey. Comment, like, subscribe, participate, always remember to share, do the important stuff that keeps this show going and this channel growing, and enjoy. And give me just a quick second here, folks. That's what the problem is. Okay, hold on. Let's see. Beasts of Prey. Okay, and almost done. Pull the background music back just a little bit. We are a live show, folks, and I'm learning a new technique for starting the show. I don't know how smoothly that went, but anyway, here we are in Beasts of Prey. Hold on, let me do a quick alteration to that. Alright, so Selwyn Davis is on. He says, aye, it started. Woo! How's it going, Selwyn? So I'm laid down. Okay. Let's do our thing. I want to go to... We're starting over on the official servers. I have a certain position I want to go to. That's not the way to go. I want west and north from where I am. Actually, let's pick a new place to go. Feel good about this direction. Let's head off this direction. I guess I want to save my running.
Hey, 13.
What's up?
Should Marisa put the Christmas tree parts in the back?
No. No. They have to go up in the attic without being in a bag. We are a live show, folks, and we're undecorating for the holidays in the studio as well. So yeah, I'll get all those up in the rafter between shows at the lunch break, which comes at 1:45. I have no idea if you heard me. I'm gonna cruise right by that dude as if we didn't notice that we just passed by a dude. There's a dude there. Man, we gotta get the hell out of here. We gotta get the hell out of here, folks. We actually want to go find a place to set up our studio set for the machinima we're gonna make. A machinima all about a group of friends, one man's need for dinosaur love, his friends, cautionary. We got some weird lighting stuffs going on. That wasn't there in the last build I played. What game is this? This is Beasts of Prey. Beasts of Prey is still in development. It's an alpha. You'll see some rough stuff. And we're really into supporting Beasts of Prey. We're a fan right from the beginning. So what we're going to be doing with Beasts of Prey here is building a machinima set. And on this machinima set, we're going to have a tale of one man's need for dinosaur love. One bastard's desire to help him fulfill those needs. And the group of friends trying to save one friend from the other. It'll be fun. It'll be the machinima we do in this. We're also building a set for a machinima in Space Engineers, and we're doing some mods. Space Engineers, because we're gonna need characters, and Don't Starve Together, just because I want to play as Cheech and Chong. I think that would be cool. I know exactly how to set those characters up. It wasn't so much that I picked Cheech and Chong for any personal political disposition that I would like to proclaim to the world. It was more just a, hey, Cheech and Chong are really cool characters, and they have kind of an obvious proclivity that I could set a character up around. We're going out there! That's where we're going. It's way the hell out there that we're gonna go. I don't mind having neighbors, I just don't want them right up my butt the whole time I'm trying to shoot a show. So we're gonna head out a bit. So the likelihood that we find neighbors who like to spend part of their time being enemas will reduce. I also, the sun I think is setting. I want the sun to set on the water prettily. From where our, we need a good view, or maybe on the water, maybe not, but it's got to be nice, and we're going to do all that. I've learned a thing or two about Beasts of Prey. This is actually the third time we've started a set. Nothing was serious until this year. This year, we got really serious. We're like, all right, not only are we going to do some machinimas, but we're also gonna build sets and all kinds of stuff like that. Alright. Yeah, the sun is setting that direction, right? Man, the sun is setting fast. We're heading into the sun. The sun rising over the water would be nice too. I don't know. But something tells me it'll be to the east either way. So we're heading to the east, sunrise, sunset. I'm not sure how it works in this world. But now we have not seen dinosaurs, and I'm kind of probably an idiot for mentioning that, because now we're immediately going to see dinosaurs. But I thought about setting up right in the middle of a forest like these guys. I don't think that really makes your place any harder to see. I don't know how well other players will be able to destroy the set. We may end up migrating to a new server eventually. Who knows? Right now, we're in it, though. And I suppose, just because I'm going to need it, I should grab wood as I come across it. So let's... we'll do that as we're starting to approach what I feel is either going to be home, or the mountain pass in which we build home, or the mountain top upon which we build home. I'm not sure. It'd be kind of cool to build home and then do like a long, access way of some sort. You can only build in this world in places that you own things. Alright, so let's collect some more wood up. Can I go around a tree and collect wood still? Wow, I cannot get any closer than that to the tree. In the past, you could get a little closer to the tree than that. That might be it. This'll be it. Okay, there was a little update for a while that kept you from being able to go around the tree and collect resources, and I like being able to go around the tree and collect resources. Can I just hold the button down? Yeah, I can. Okay. I forgot. Alright, that's a lot of wood for one tree. It's kind of an awesome tree. Let's see. We still want to go to the east, but I want to do that one more time. That worked out rather well. This time we'll walk until we start collecting resources. I'm assuming at 4 points around the tree. Whoa! Holy shit! You... damn it! I suspect that was automated. I suspect that was automated. I do. Now we're gonna be all the way back to spawn. Okay. Awesome. All the way back to spawn. Okay, well, hell, I'm heading west this time. I think I still have my wood, though. I don't. I lost my wood as well. Okay, so apparently when you get killed, you lose everything. That is all kinds of fun. Hello? There we go. It was not moving for a second. Hey, Silver is on. How's it going, Silver? I got gunned down. That was crazy. Man. Gotta be careful of getting too close to somebody's place. I feel... Damn it! I was just about to say, I feel damn nervous about being close to anything now. Crap! Scares the shit out of me when it happens. Alright, I think I'm gonna switch to a PvE server. So, I'm gonna... Yeah, I know the intro music in this game is completely evil. So I'm gonna bring up... We're gonna lose sound for a second, guys. Just while I go out to the lobby. I've never done the PvP server before, and I was thinking, well, PvP might add something cool to the machinima, but I'm an idiot, and I'm gonna go ahead and do the PvE, where we won't have to face total eradication like that. That was not a good thing to face, and I think that we're gonna avoid it in the future as we can. Now hopefully you guys can't hear the sound going on here, because if so, that sucks. I'm gonna get a copyright violation for it. But let's join official and let's do the official PvE in the Netherlands. And then once the music stops from the game, there we go. Okay. We'll bring sound back up. Alright. There we go. So. West. We will go west. West, young man. Go west. Alright. So we'll set our setup on the official PvE server then. That was most non-spectacular. Ah, somebody's already got the mountain fortress going. Now the continent is supposed to be pretty big. The light, they still have to work on the light a bit. I feel like the spotlight shouldn't be able to wash the day out like that. Or it should shut off during the day cycle. But yeah, that's looking a little hokey. Still, but it is an alpha. Okay, we got a lovely lake here. Oh my god, I see where our land is. Holy shnikey. I don't believe nobody ever built there. There's a space like between sections of the lake or where the water is low or something. There's like a peninsula there. It's got a little water to both sides of it. That is freaking home. That's where we're homing it. We're homulating over there. Lots of people started stuff they never built. We're going to get down there and discover somebody owns it. I just know it. I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't just go for the first lovely spot that I find, but that is a lovely spot. Okay, there's a bird. Crap! Son of a... Son of a dinosaur! It's a rather dangerous place. This Jurassic era, like, it's not Jurassic era, I'm sure, but that bastard, what the hell was he doing? Eating my clavicle like that. That jerk. Yep, PvE. I don't know if PvE has more dinosaurs in it or what, but... That jerk. Next time, don't turn around and see what's eating you. Run! Run, little Sparky, run! Run from that dinosaur! That was some effed up stuff. That dinosaur got more of a piece of me than I would have preferred. That was crazy. Okay. I keep hearing sounds. Oh my god. It's terrifying now. I think that's part of the music that I'm hearing. What the hell? I've been gunned down and eaten by a dinosaur in fairly short succession. And a reminder to our community, whenever we're doing stuff that's in-game, you're always welcome to join us. Friend us on Steam. If you're one of our Steam friends, feel free to reach out and we'll send you a chat link and get you into the game. And you can join us. We like gaming with you folks. We don't want these machinimas and mods and stuff to be things that are just ours. And even when I'm working on mods, I may end up having some of our... What? No sticky keys. I may end up inviting some of our Steam friends to go ahead and invite us during that process as well. But we'll find out. See how all that goes. I think if you're, I don't know, maybe it would be really nerve-wracking to have an artist in there. Selwyn Davis says, speaking of dinos, you should play Hunter Primal. I don't own Hunter Primal. If I owned a copy of it, I would shoot it. Anytime anybody wants us to shoot a game, the best way to get us to do it is to be our friend on Steam and to send us a copy. Because if you send us a copy of a game, we are obligated immediately to shoot it. And to shoot a reasonable number of episodes of it. So that we're not kind of being jerks to your generosity. So if you want to control and shape what we shoot in the show... Whoa, I got a stone axe just by selecting it. That was... Oh no! Okay, we've played on this server before. And our home is gone. But our stuff is not. That I'm carrying at least. That's a fantastic... That's great! That's a good start on things. I like that. I think I'm gonna like this. It's too bad that we're not on the server that I have the automatic weaponry and stuff. That one's gone. One of the reasons we're doing... This is Silent Partner. Summon the Island, by the way. That's the background music playing right now. Silent Partner is the band. Summon the Island is the name of the tune. So anyway... We had a lot of stuff on another server. So Selwyn Davis says, and on an unrelated note, do you have Skyrim? I do not have Skyrim. I played the heck out of it on the console version on the 360 and the, yeah, that was the 360. I played it with a mouse on the 360 actually and absolutely rocked. I'd love to play it on Steam, but I don't own it. The best way to know what we own is to friend us on Steam and snoop. Just look. Got 84 titles. I don't want to ramble them off every couple of episodes, and that's what'll happen if I start rambling them off. But what we will do is we'll always keep the door open for you guys to be Steam friends of ours. Once we get to our cap of Steam friends, then we're just going to start... every once in a while kicking people out of the boat that we haven't seen be active for a while. We'll send you a lovely message. Hey, we're about to kick you out of the boat. It's not that we don't love you. It's just that these spots are very important to be available to people who are actively going to participate in the blah 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 yakety smackety. And then we'll kick you the hell out. Was that a dinosaur? Should I be in an ass ball? Okay, I'm in an ass ball. Okay, I'm gonna crouch. I'm almost where I'm trying to get to. And that's either somebody's pet dinosaur or it's a jerk-ass dinosaur waiting to eat me because I've almost made it to where I'm going. I swear I'm hearing all kinds of dinosaur stuff, but it might be just my imagination enkindled by the music. Or someone's vacuuming upstairs. Someone's vacuuming upstairs.
Yeah.
That was the growling I was hearing. Holy cripe. Okay, well, whatever. Snikes. Let's cruise out this way. Great and lard-like snikes. Alright, so there's rock. It's the wrong kind of rock. I'm going to want some stuff to be able to make our, you know, post our home. And then I'll write down the coordinates to that. And then after that, we need a bed to be able to save or to set our spawn point. So we'll do all that. Right now, it's just due west to the coast. Actually, I like that squarish cliff up there. I like the cut of its jib. Its jib is quite jibular. If I get up there and that's a flat platform, I might be overwhelmingly motivated to build my home there. And in our home, we will build a fortress. And after we have a fortress, we'll have dude that loves the dinosaurs. I don't know. There may be a time that we end up doing this whole series in full PvP, but right now, since I'm the only lad doing the effort, I feel like I have to do it in PvE, because there's just too many damn things to kill you when everybody's house wants to kill you and all the dinosaurs want to kill you. Did somebody it works. Somebody has an oil derelict that actually looks like it might derelict up here. Man, damn, I thought I found the place to be, but all these people already have places here. It's like trying to move to California. We'll go this way. So Silver says, I'm playing games, and when I heard the dinosaur that attacked you, it scared the crap out of me. Yeah, well, that's awesome that you're playing games, Paul. Nice community effort in helping me set up the machinima set. I see where your priorities are. Let's cruise over here. Silver is also known as Paul. He's one of our regulars on games and stuff. Although he kind of faded off. I think we stopped being interesting to Paul. And off he went. Okay, there's that. And, by the way, also, since it scared the crap out of you, I suggest that you wipe. So this is the west. We're gonna have beautiful sunsets, I guess. Okay, I'm thinking I might. I don't like it. I don't like it. It feels like a damn swamp. Maybe over there. I still want the sunset. Maybe over there, though. It's got to be someplace, you know, worthwhile. Worthy of building a set for a machinima. That's a really nice cottage you have there, sir. But I cannot open it. I don't think you can open the cottages yet, which is a good reason not to build a bed inside of one, as we learned in an earlier episode of Beasts of Prey. And there was a process that kind of went into learning some of this stuff. You can see that in our earlier episodes. And I am actually making some intelligent decisions here, believe it or not. I'm gonna grab some of this while we're going through. I suppose I should pick it up while I chop it. It's the best way to keep it from despawning. That it? That's it. Alright. We got some stone. Do I got wood too? I think I got 4 wood logs. I got so much raw stone. Holy criminy. I'm going to be able to build the platform in all of its glory. Oh, that's beautiful. In all of its glory. I like that big fern right there. I'd love to have that right in the middle of the home. Also, this guy's got a bench going. What do you got on your bench? Anything? Nothing on your bench? I can't pick your bench up. There used to be a time when you could just pick somebody's bench up. I was going to have a free bench there. But I guess you can't do that in this updated version. Okay, kind of like what's going on here. Somebody's... Oh boy, you get slow in the waters. Is it worth walking all the way around, though? I don't think so. Let's go for the slow push. Straight across. Ah, oh, damn it. Neighbors. That's okay. My setting sun is a little bit farther around. Let's see. You can. You can open one now. What can I open now, Paul? Paul says I can open one now. What was I talking about that led him to say I could open one now? Time passes, Paul, between what I see and what you type. I'm going to reduce that time, but it's still going to exist. Okay. Let's keep cruising across the bay here. I am the best swimmer ever. I'm swimming with my axe out with one arm and 3 legs. Three legs. And you can't even see that there's a ripple. It's the third leg that makes me so stable as I'm cruising through the water here. Third leg power. If I look down, you can see me swimming with it, but it's kind of gross, so I'm just going to... Hold on. I'm not sure why our playlist decided to stop, but it did. There we go. I felt the need to get the funky back. Kind of like the idea of building the house in that crevice. That's quite an installation. We're going to get nothing built this episode. It's just going to be an episode that I spend the whole time getting there. Okay, hold on here. There we go. I don't know what to say. It's incredibly important to find the right place for the show. You know? Kind of a funky tune. I'm glad there's no water dinosaurs. All of a sudden. But around this corner in that crevice seems like it may be a stupidly far distance to go. So that may be the key to everything. Stupidity. Once again, is the key to everything. Next is Don't Starve Together mod. Working on that Cheech and Chong mod in Don't Starve Together. Very excited about that. There's a rainbow reflected in the water. Oh, never mind. That's the sun flare from that light. Well, there's the sun going to be setting soon, and that's beautiful. The nice thing is, once we find a place for home, we can set it up right away. It's just a matter of actually getting there and setting up home. I don't know why I'm drawn to set a place up on the water, because it's not like you need the water for anything, nor can you make boats or anything at this point in the game, but I don't know. Whatever. You go with what feels good sometimes. But that crevice looks like it'll feel good. Crevice, in my experience in life, crevice is a source of good feelings. So we're heading for it. It's taking forever. Oh, Selwyn Davis. Is there any crafting in Primal Hunter? Or Hunter Primal? Or is it kind of like a... Oh, hey, there's land here. Is there any crafting in Primal Hunter? Or is it more like a Dino Hunter type of game where you're just kicking dino ass the whole time? And that's kind of what you're doing. It's going to get a bit dark. We're going to build the house in the dark, which is always a great thing to do. Okay, we might not be able to get into the crevice, which means it'll be a lot like high school. Oh yeah, okay. All right. The crevice was easier than I thought it was going to be. Therefore, it's more like college. But once I got to the crevice, I saw another crevice that I might want, which might make it more like high school. I don't know. Could. It's like the island of Woongabi over here is waiting for us. Oh, some bastard built his stuff on the way to the island of Woongabi. At any time, oh son of a cock! Oh, sorry about that. Son of a snikey. Still, bastard came out here and built on the island of Woongabi. It's my island! It might be my island, I don't know. Still trying to figure that out. Still looking for the best place. I figure the best plan is just to find it in the dark when we can't actually see anything. Do we want to be on the backside of an island? It's difficult to get to the place of. Do we? It's a nice little cove over there. There's a bunch of trees around the corner. I think that's going to be a lovely view right there. Let me come around to the west side of the island. See if we get anything that makes me feel like it's going to be a great idea to build here. Right now I'm feeling a little trepidatious about it. Oh, there's a little inlet. I kind of like that. Alright, so we'll do it. We'll build. We got to find just the right height at which to build. Okay. First, we will craft. We will craft a. What? I need wood planks. Okay. We'll we'll make wood planks twice and see if that gives us enough wood planks. Guess not. Let's make two more wood planks. Or wood planks twice more. And then I think that's all the wood planks I can make. So if that's not enough, this is not where we're setting up. This is not home. Screw this place. I don't know who said this was home, but that person didn't know what the hell they were talking about. My God, this episode is just going to be finding home. I have no idea. It's like all those times that I couldn't find home. That guy was an ass. He should have built right here. But I don't want to be his next door neighbor. Because I know that he makes cheese. And you don't ever want to live next to somebody who makes cheese as a hobby or a living. And that dude makes cheese like no other. He grunts when he makes cheese. Grunts that cheese right out. In a big cheese hammer. And then if I lived next to him, every time I saw him, he'd be all, you know, wanting to talk about cheese. And if I wasn't like, hey man, how's the hammer hanging? He'd be all offended because I'd have no interest in his cheese hammer. And I'm not sure that I'm willing to have those kinds of obligations with my neighbors. I'm noticing a slight glitch. I ran through a bunch of water. And now I have no stamina. The stamina just will not charge. All I can do is very slowly prowl across the land. It's just kind of crappy. Hey, developers, did you know that your stamina is broken? And that now my stamina is broken? I can only move as... Yeah, I'm not crouching or anything. And I can't jump. So it's acting as if I have no stamina. But I feel fine. Yeah, baby. You tell them. Oh, cock. There's another house there. Alright, well. That is no fun at all. Silver says, well, one thing, there's no cow to produce milk to make cheese. Silver, I don't know if you don't know about dinosaur cheese. Apparently you don't. And I will assure you that dinosaur cheese is stinkier than cow's milk cheese. So, you should just watch how you are not judgmental about our neighbors for their cheese-making habits. Because, it'll get in your way. It'll become a thing. You know, you'll care about it if it happens to you. I can go a little bit faster than I can in the water, because in the water you're just super slow. I should have went the other way around. Alright, well... I'm hoping to find a hinterland around the corner. I also wish I had something to eat that would give me stamina, but I don't see anything. I've got a pickaxe from before, though. And that's pretty cool. Gotta appreciate that. I'm going to get all the way around the corner and get eaten by a dinosaur, end of episode. We're almost there. I'm just going to head to the eastern corner of this peninsula. And I think we may hang out there. That might be our home. Or I'm going to call this episode Wandering Around Like an Idiot to be continued in the next episode. Because I am beginning to feel like that might be what this episode is. Just wandering around like an idiot. Actually, with this whole stamina broken and won't recharge thing, that's kind of bullshit. Just a little bit difficult to get anywhere when you're not staminated. What I might do is once I reach the 45 minute mark, wherever the hell I'm standing on the beach, that might be home. Oh, that's right, we need logs. Totally chopping this tree down. Because we're almost home. If nothing else, wherever I am on the beach, if we have somebody that lives right next to us, then we'll just have to make cheese with them. Maybe she's hot. That's the best kind of cheese to make. Cheese of hotness. And be like, hey, baby, you want to make some hot cheese? She'd be like, yeah, I think I'm going to make some hot cheese with you. You fine thing. And then hot cheese would be made. That's how the original queso dip was originally originated. The hot people making hot dip together. Come on, get out of there. Okay, there is a beach coming. Actually, we should be down at the beach. Looking at the time on the wall, we should be down at the beach. We really should. We're getting to the point, though, that we have some nice views. When the sun comes up, it's going to come up over that corner rise, and I'm down with that. That's acceptable. There's no people real close to here. There are trees close. We're on a hillside, around the corner is decent resources. So I'm thinking this isn't so bad. What is that out there? Is that a tree out there? What the hell is that out there in the water? Does the land curve back around that direction? Why is there... This is the perfect place. It's got the ghost tree in the water. We're gonna have to walk out to that someday. Now, I'd like to have these woods to the back of the house or even involved in it. So that's why I'm continuing to come over here. In fact, I'd like a little inlet direction to the land, perhaps, if we can manage it. But we'll check that out. Oh. Oh. I think I do like this. I like what's coming up over here. Yep. I think all of our hard work has paid off, folks. All of our patience. I think it's getting dark again. Oh no, it's going to become light. That's right, it gets really dark right before it's light. This is what I want. I found exactly what I want. Oh my. The patience is always worth it. You know what I'm saying, folks? The patience is always worth it. When you're willing to go ahead and say, all right, this is what I'm looking for, and I'm going to hang in here until I get what I'm looking for. That's the best way. So this is where we're going to build. We need to do a little more wood planking. Okay, and we have wood planked. And I'm just going to make a little note here of our current location. Okay. Note made. Good. Now, let's make... We're doing it, folks. We finally have the perfect place. Really? How many damn wood planks do you get from a piece of wood? Feel like that's all you're gonna get, unless I have to make more. Okay, let's make one of those. Good. Inventory. Let's grab that and put it down here. And we will put our claim flag. Oh. We'll put our claim flag right. Let's see. There's the east. Put it so it faces the east. Excellent. Excellent, excellent. Now we need to go into crafting. Oh, sorry. Crafting here and make foundation stones. Lots of them. Actually, they're really expensive, so I guess we can't make lots, but we can get a couple laid down here. Okay. Yeah, only five. So let's grab these. And let's build. Really? Let's build straight into the water. As far as we can. Okay, that's as far out into the water as we can go. Alright, and then we'll go as far out those directions in a T as we can go. But we have our location. We have our setup. This, folks, is where we're going to be setting things up. And it's now time, if I can get a little control over my cursor, to say thanks so much for joining us, folks. Comment, like, subscribe, participate. Always remember to share. Do the important stuff that keeps this show going and this channel growing. And we'll see you next time. And next time will be in about 13 minutes at 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time for an episode of Modding Don't Starve. Making Cheech and Chong. We'll see you then.